today I'm going to make for you my Lovage Pesto with almonds. This is delicious. You may recall we talked about Lovage when Jill and I made her farro salad, and it was a newer herb that I put in my garden, and we weren't sure if you said Lovage or Lovage. Well, it's Lovage. And it's actually really popular in Europe. The Romanians like it, the English really like it, but it is a very hardy plant. It grows very resistant to bugs and pests, and it is really delicious. And I really had a hard time trying to figure out what to do with it. And I have so much of it that I wanted to make a pesto, but the pesto had a bitterness to it because it really has a strong celery taste to it. It's a cross between celery and parsley, and it looks like a big leaf of Italian flat leaf parsley. So I was looking around for some recipes, and my buddy said, I've got this recipe with almonds and lemon and cream cheese. Makes it really creamy, and it really takes that bite out. And if you are not familiar with this plant, I suggest you get some Lovage seeds or find the plant, but this thing grows. It's not a spreader, it grows up, but it is a wonderful addition to your herb garden. So let's get started, and we'll go over the ingredient list for my Lovage pesto with almonds. For this recipe, you'll need 3 cups of loosely packed Lovage leaves, 2 garlic cloves, juice and zest from 1 lemon, 1/2 cup of sliced almonds, 1/2 cup of grated Parmesan or Romano cheese, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1/4 teaspoon of nutmeg, 1/3 cup of cream cheese, and 1/4 to 1/2 cup of extra virgin olive oil. Well, I de-stemmed and I washed and dried these Lovage leaves very thoroughly because I don't want them to get mushy. You want them to remain, you know, pretty crisp, and you don't want them to lose their pretty color. So we will put that in the bowl of the food processor, and make sure you use the blade attachment. Then I'm going to add 2 cloves of garlic. You can add more if you like it, and I'm a garlic fan, and I thought 2 was more than adequate. And then I'm going to add the almonds. You can use slivered too, but I had these already in the freezer. And I'm going to now put the zest in. So remember to not go too deep. You don't want to get the white pith. You just want the bright yellow part of the lemon. And then I'm just going to cut that in half and juice it directly in the bowl. I love this little gadget. I can't remember where I got it, but it really juices the citrus nice, and then the little holes pick up the seeds. And now what we're gonna do is just put the lid on and just pulse it until it's all broken up. Yep, it looks great. I will add 1/2 cup of cheese. I'm using Romano because I like it better, but Parmesan works just as well. And I'm going to add the cream cheese. This is what makes this pesto. I know it seems weird, but it's good. So we're gonna drop that in. And then the nutmeg. Nutmeg is perfect for Lovage. I'm not sure what it is, but they're both very warm tasting, and I think that helps. And then about 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Don't forget, you can always adjust and add more salt, but you're getting a lot of salt from the cheese. All right, so now I'm going to run it on, and through the tube, I'm gonna keep adding oil. And I kind of know what kind of consistency I want. I don't want it to be too oily. So I'm gonna do, I think this is looking good. Yeah, let's check it out. I'll scrape it down and we'll see. Oh yeah, that's just about right. And I think I added about 1/4 cup. So let's do one more run. Oh yeah. But just a little bit more to loosen it up. we'll just put this all in a bowl. Now, as you can see, this is a pretty generous cup. I'd say almost 2 cups. So now let's add, I like to add a little bit of the sauce at the bottom, you know, and mix about half of it together. And then always reserve a little bit of pasta water in case you don't think it's loose enough. And I think that we will be adding that. So now I'll add the rest.
Do you want some pasta water?
I got the pasta water right here. And then we'll add a little bit more. Be generous. This is your main course, or I guess it could be a side. And then I'm just gonna add a little bit of pasta water to loosen it, see? And you just, oops, one escaped. And you just mix that all together, and honestly, it is so good. So there we have it. Doesn't that look great?
It does.
Look at the beautiful color. Now, you had this the other night. You've been one of my little guinea pigs,
yes,
for all my dishes.
Yes.
Well, as a pasta sauce, it's excellent.
Oh, it's delicious.
And it makes a great little dip. Look at my little baby little dip plate.
Put it in.
And then you can also put it like under cream cheese or under goat cheese and, you know, layer it up. I mean, it's really good. Ken put it on his bagel this morning. Can't beat that.
No.
All right, so let's see. You could add additional cheese, but I don't think it needs it.
I never put cheese in mine. It's so good.
I just love this Lovage.
And you know it's my favorite color.
Green. Now, what is fresh and sparkling and has a little bit of a carbonation to it, and it's very reasonably priced, it's from Portugal, the Vino Verde. And it comes from a lot of different labels, but the Casal Garcia is probably the most famous. I love this stuff, and it's lower in alcohol. It's a really nice, sessionable wine.
Oh, it's nice. It's kind of sparkly.
Yeah, because it's not in the tanks long. Kind of ferment. It's really, really good. I love this stuff. So, go to my website, CaseyMaloneShow.com, and look for my Lovage Pesto with almonds. I can't remember what to do it. And you are going to love it and get some Lovage in that garden.
It's wonderful.
Love, love, love it.
Love it, love it.
Cheers.